poverty can be a state of mind. And I agree with Dr. Benjamin Carson. So many people talking shit about him. That's a dude that came from poverty. And I recommend you check out the context of his comment when he said that during a radio interview. I'm going to mess up the direct quote, but he said something like, at a state of mind where that's in poverty. It's conditioned by, can be conditioned by, the parents. Were you the teacher to be a winner or a loser? Showing them what is possible. And you could give someone who's has a poor state of mind. He had said that if you give someone with a poor state of mind a lot of money, all the resources, soon enough they'll be at the bottom. And if you take away everything from someone who has doesn't have a mindset in poverty, that they'll quickly rise, not quickly, but they will rise to the top again. This artwork, this video channel, all this shit on here is created with a high school diploma. I give credit to just one art teacher. Showed me how to simply focus and enjoy this more than anything technical. And man, what an amazing woman, amazing teacher that I had. Just a great person who happened to be my art teacher. What I could have done, I could have followed the steps of a lot of stupid fucking parents. Oh, you gotta look cool, you gotta be hip, you need to get brownie points, you need to be liked, not loved. It's more important to be liked than loved. And when that's your focus, I believe one starts to lose their genuine identity. Let's say your neighborhood, your high school, your community, your tribe is big on football. Someone tells you to join the football team, but deep down inside you want to be a rugby player, or a soccer player, tennis player. Something other than football. And people will try to convince you, tell you, oh, dog, come on, man, why are you trying to be so hard? Try the year of this football. Or you do the year, and you're like, oh, come on, you're doing so good, just do another year. Peer pressure, not knowing anything else besides what's within the limited minds of your tribe, you continue. And you don't pursue your genuine self. Me, I've been fortunate enough to somehow continue on pursuing my interests. Learning, studying, practicing, a lot of shit. and hearing shit like, oh, that's stupid. What's that for? That's some gay shit. That's bullshit. That's weak. That's boring. What good is that for? That's not real money. You should focus on doing something constructive with your life. And other things. Just pure, I won't say pure negativity, but just a lot of negativity. A lot of doubting. But these are people who don't have the fucking balls nor the fucking guts to take their own medicine. And me, I've failed plenty of times. I'm like, shit, fucking up. Oops, that didn't work. Okay, let's try again. Damn, how can I make it work? Oh, that didn't work. Oops, I fucked up. What can I go learn some more? And I pursued insight, education, training, advice. Where to get tools, certain tools, better tools, more tools, new tools. And I kept on going. And I can't tell you what it was that made me like that. I'm thinking television to a point where even watching Twilight Zone giving me a macabre taste for reality. Made me wonder. Looking at drawings, wondering, damn, how did they do that? Wonder if I could do something like that. But it's, I think I'm lucky enough not to have fallen into the trap of, you know what's really, you know what my goal is, you know what a real goal is, you know what success is, having a five bedrooms, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 20 bedroom house, having the next year's Mercedes, let me buy diamonds, let me buy worthless diamonds to put a hang around my neck. Oh man, you know what? That bitch, she has no personality. No character. She's merely a cutout with looks. A person that just simply follows the Kardashian whores and looks pretty. Looks real good, butt naked and bent over. Yeah, that's the Ultima. The ultimate. And it's funny seeing people think, yeah, you know what, that's it, you know, family, job, that's it, I got it, dog, look at you, you're alone. And I think of them when they know deep down inside that they are not happy where they are at. They are living with someone, sleeping with someone that they are being dishonest with. They are at a job where they serve and express a fake smile. Under breaks, the lookout out the window, out into the ceiling fan. And wonder, man, how did I get here? Fucked up. how do I know that those are the thoughts of certain people? Certain people that I've met, older people, have told me that. That's what's on their mind. Be careful, man. Be careful how you do this. You don't want to be end up here in this position. Again, a point that I made a few times already. Are the words of Jim Rohn, which are, do not simply just focus on your resources. Focus on being resourceful. And for me, as I pursue my exit strategy out of my fiscal poverty, fiscal, not mental, fiscal, I remind myself that I need to keep on going. I could easily say, oh shit, look at me, man. How many sales did I do this week? Last week? Last month? Oh my god, I'm just getting older. What's all this for? I ain't gonna make it.